Hello, my artist friends and visitors, and welcome to Monet Cafe. I hope you enjoy this painting demonstration that I'm sharing now. This was just one of those times where I just wanted to paint. I just kind of needed that mental break, and don't you guys, I know a lot of you can relate to that, how the stresses of life and everything can be sometimes frustrating and overwhelming at times, and the creation process of painting, drawing, is such an outlet, and it's so therapeutic. And so this time I had a crazy past few weeks. Everything's still a little nutty with our lives since the flooding of our home. Things are coming together, but it's still far from normal. And so sometimes my painting is stretched out over a few days, so I'll sneak in a little time here and there. But the neat thing is, I know you guys can relate. That's the beautiful thing about this channel, I think, and also the Monet Cafe Art Group on Facebook, is that we all have so much in common. You know, it's funny, in a world where everybody is divisive and speaking of so many differences and people are on one side of an issue or another, I think we're all really celebrating just the camaraderie and the connection that we have on this channel, in art in general, and as a group in Monet Cafe on Facebook, because I love being able to see your work and hear what you guys have to say. So, man, it just feels like a family, doesn't it? I just love you guys. So I'm not going to give as much instruction in this video. I think I'm just going to let you guys watch the process. It's only sped up 4 times. I know some artists will speed it up. You've got different degrees of how you can fast forward this. And I don't ever like to do it too fast because you can't even see what I'm doing. And so this one's only sped up 4 times. But this is in case you're wondering what this bright red thing is I'm painting on with pastels, it's a board that I have created myself. I do have a few videos on how you can create your own pastel surfaces. Not only do pastel papers, sanded papers, get expensive, but sometimes I like the results of making my own board better than a really smooth pastel paper that's already available for sale. The reason is because if you like the loose painterly style, often you can get your strokes that you use to apply your surface to kind of show through, and it just has that neat artistic feel to it. So this is a piece of foam core board. One of the techniques I often use where I take foam core board or matte board, a lot of people have shared you can get scraps of matte board, like people make mats in frame shops, and often they will give you scraps for free. So you can use that matte board as well to make your own painting surfaces. So this is a piece of foam board, and I painted on my concoction. I think this one was with fine pumice gel and an acrylic paint that's very translucent. Notice how brilliant that reddish, orangish, pinkish color is. I like to keep the translucence, the brilliance of the white paper still kind of in there. If you pick a real opaque color, it's going to look kind of dead. So that's why I usually pick underpainting colors that are brighter like that. So you'll probably have already seen where I put up the little information icon where you can click if you want to see how to make your own boards like this. It's a lot of fun. It's good to kind of set some time for yourself just to have an afternoon of making your own pastel surfaces. And then the neat thing is they're all ready for you. And sometimes it's just inspiring. Like, I have all these different colors of these boards I've made, and sometimes just pulling out one that has a certain color tone to it, it just kind of gets me in a creative mood and is very just creative in itself. So as you can see, I'm doing a lot of Terry Ludwig pastels. They're the big chunky square ones. And notice sometimes I paint with my right hand too. That's simply because sometimes it's more convenient on that side of the paper or the board. And a lot of you, if some of you are left-handed, you will realize and relate to what I'm saying, is that left-handed people have to learn to be pretty ambidextrous because we're in a right-handed world. And often, like when I was in school, we didn't have left-handed scissors, hardly ever, you know, so I learned to cut right-handed. And so that's kind of an advantage that usually left-handed people are somewhat able to perform with their right hand. So, and also you may want to try painting with your opposite hand just because it gives, we get in patterns or habits with our dominant hand of strokes being a certain way or a certain flow to it. And often if you switch hands, you'll get a little variation and sometimes more creativity when you try that. So just, you know, give it a try sometimes. So now I'm just going to let you guys enjoy this process. And I wanted to say how much I appreciate you all. It's been a little melancholy the last week, losing a pastel artist friend that I had never physically met, but I had been her friend online, actually before Facebook, on a website for artists called Wet Canvas. I learned of her pastel work. She's been doing pastel work longer than I have. Her name is Paula Ann Ford, and I admired her pastel work for years. And she was always so helpful and so generous to answer questions of anybody in the wet canvas, soft pastel part of it. There's different forums in wet canvas. It might be something you want to check out. Just find the soft pastel forum, and there's artists sharing their work, kind of similar to Monet Cafe Art Group on Facebook. But anyway, so Paula was just a beautiful soul, and she loved God's earth. And she just recently lost her battle with cancer, but she was a believer, and I can only imagine what beauty she's experiencing right now. So we miss her. And so I'm going to dedicate this video to her. And I know a lot of you know her if you're in our group on Facebook and you've already expressed your condolences. And so anyway, let us just all enjoy every precious moment that we have on this earth. Let's keep sharing and growing and loving and painting. Yes. All right. Enjoy this. I might pop back in a minute.